We just got to Block Island. We took the high-speed ferry out of Point Judith, and it was so much better than the slow ferry. It was like 20 minutes. And right now we're walking to Spring House Hotel to see if they'll hold our bags for the day so we don't need to bring them to the beach with us. Good man. Yeah. Check back in when we get to the hotel. This is the hotel that we're staying at for the night.
Water views.
Can you guess where we are on Block Island? We are at the famous Boar. They're famous for their mudslides. And this is our view. Okay, guys, just got back to the room.
A little drunk.
How cute is this? There we go. So cute. Has AC. And can see the water right from outside our room. Where's the bathroom? It's so cute in here. Okay, guys. Jonathan hates when I'm vlogging. Hates it. Just woke up from a nap. Feel a lot better. Going to go. Where is it? Poor People. I think it's called Poor People's Tavern. So, what?
Pub.
Poor People's Pub. So, we're gonna go there for dinner and yeah, that's where we're gonna go.
Wow, that's a lot of barbecue sauce.
We're at Poor People's Pub. Both got a beer. I got their pulled pork mac and cheese. It's their specialty. They make the pulled pork here. What did you get? A burger?
Yeah.
What kind of burger? What kind of burger?
Local burger.
Local burger with no tomato.
Yeah.
And I'm taking his pickle. But they make the pulled pork here, and mac and cheese is like their specialty, so I'm about to go. Good morning, it's Sunday. I woke up with this beauty on my face, but it's fine, I'm happy, it's beautiful outside. I wanted to just kind of break down my day yesterday. I didn't really get into detail about everywhere we went, so I thought I would do that for you guys. So we took the 9 a.m. high-speed ferry out of Point Judith, and it was awesome. We got to the island in 20 minutes. So it was well worth waking up early, and the 45-minute drive really wasn't that serious. And I think the ferry cost us like $20 each one way, which is so inexpensive compared to like $70 out of Fall River for a two-hour ride. Not worth it. So we went right to Spring House Hotel. They held our bags for us, which was so nice. The hotel is really, really, really pretty. It just has that awesome nautical beach vacation vibe. And we dropped them off, and then we walked over to, I don't really know what the beach is called, but when you get off of the ferry and you walk to the right instead of the left to go to Ballard's, there's a little beach over there that you can go to. And I rented a chair, we rented an umbrella, and we hung out there for a little bit. It was nice. It was beautiful, beautiful weather. We actually, one thing I will say is that we did not plan accordingly for this. We should have brought one of our vehicles. I really wanted to show him like the whole island, and it just wasn't possible. We were gonna rent a car, but that was gonna be $200 to rent a car until 7 o'clock at night, which is crazy. And it was like $100 an hour to rent a car. But if you drive around and then you stop somewhere, you kind of eat up your time. So it really wasn't worth it. A cab ride on the island is $12, no matter where you're going or where you're coming from. I promise you, it's always $12. Cabs are definitely very hectic here, for sure hectic, but they get you where you need to be. So we jumped in a cab and we went to the Or for lunch. I wanted to have him try their famous mudslides. They're so good. So we got mudslides. We had lunch right on the big Adirondack chairs overlooking the harbor. New Harbor, overlooking New Harbor. So Old Harbor is where you come in with the ferries, and New Harbor is on the opposite side where a lot of people keep their boats. So we had lunch there. Lobster roll wasn't really worth it. It's definitely cheaper, but for the amount of meat that they put in it, it was pretty expensive. And I don't know, it wasn't the best lobster roll I've ever had. He had the fried shrimp tempura, which was good. The honey sriracha wings were phenomenal. Like, so crispy, had a little bit of heat to them, but were super sweet. They were awesome. And then mozzarella sticks. That was fine. We sat outside, which is first come, first serve, so you kind of have to act like a seagull and just stake your spot, but it was fine. After that, we got notified by Springhouse Hotel that our room was ready early, so we jumped back in a cab again, $12, and came back to the hotel, and I took a 3-hour nap. I needed a nap. I showered to get all the sunscreen off me, which took off my self tanner, but whatever, and took a 3-hour nap. Jonathan just watched a Winston Churchill movie, and then we went out, and that's kind of where I kicked back in with vlogging. So we went to Poor People's Pub, and it was good. Since I ate lunch and then took a 3-hour nap, I was still pretty full because none of my food fully digested, so I wasn't that hungry, and I still got pulled pork mac and cheese, and I probably had 3 bites of it, and I still feel so guilty about that because it was such a waste of food. The drinks were really good, the service was good, and staying here overnight is definitely a way different experience than just coming here for the day. It was nice to just not see tourists leave, because I'm a tourist, but to not have the huge crowds here was really cool. The shop stayed open pretty late. I was surprised about that. You can walk around everywhere. Cabs are still running at night. There's bikes, there's police. Like, it's very safe. We did not eat or have a drink at the Springhouse Hotel last night, but it was very active. If you're gonna be staying here, definitely book dinner ahead of time, because as we were coming back from the Or yesterday, the reservations were booked until 9 o'clock at night. So if you plan on eating here, definitely get that all set, because it's beautiful. You overlook the water. I'll show you the view again from our hotel room. I watched the sunrise this morning because I'm corny and don't ever sleep. But yeah, that's kind of it. I would highly recommend staying at Springhouse Hotel. It's beautiful. The room is really nice. It's huge, honestly. You can walk anywhere, just bring walking shoes. The food has been great everywhere. Everyone's been super friendly. Our cab driver gave us a ton of recommendations. Today we are going to get ready, go grab some breakfast, and then head down to Ballard's to start the day. I don't know if we'll stay there or not, but that's what we're gonna do right now. So I will check back in with you guys at breakfast. So we just left the surf hotel for breakfast. It was actually our best meal here. I had French toast with caramelized bananas, and he had the green egg and ham sandwich. It was so good. It's beautiful out today. We're walking to Ballard's right now, and yeah. It's always gonna be another mountain. He has no idea.
Nothing. What?
What's
funny? Nothing's funny, babe. Jesus.
Oh, you're so funny. You're so funny. I knew it. I knew it. I called.
Okay, guys, we're vlogging. I have Brooke with me.
Hi, guys.
We're at Ballard's right now. We surprised Jonathan. I tried to catch it on camera. It did not work out at all. Brooke was hiding, like, behind him. I don't know how he didn't see her. And Jonathan's dad was popping up like a meerkat. He was, like, head tilting all over the place. But we're at the cabana. I'm going to try and say hi.
Hi.
This is for the vlog.
All my calculus and math and science and all that.
I don't even know what I'm getting. Can you see the birthday boy? Say hi.
What is that?
For the channel.
A live video?
No, it's not a live video.
What is that?
For YouTube. For YouTube. So we successfully. So we successfully surprised Jonathan. Everyone he loves is here, so that's all that matters.
Do you want to say something? No.
Do you want to say something?
I want to get paid for that. I want to get paid.
Tell the camera how much you love your son on his 30th birthday?
A little bit, just a little bit.
Go ahead. You brought him into the world, your first child. How much do you love him?
He's all right.
Oh, my God. That's it. Luge, come on.
No.
Luge, it's your firstborn. Your firstborn.
Give the cigarette.
The cigarette.
No, I don't talk.
That's pretty much it. We went to the cabana. It was a lot of fun.
That's pretty much it.
Yeah. We took shots.
We did not take a lot of shots because I can't personally handle that. We took shots.
Happy birthday, dear Jonathan. Happy birthday.
Just got back from Block Island. We are in traffic on our way to go pick up Callie, but we had the best weekend. Am I confident in saying that?
Yes, it was very fun.
We had the best weekend. He was very happy. His family was there, friends, my family. It was a lot of fun. So I think it was a successful birthday weekend. Ballard's is always a great time. Rent a cabana, rent chairs, rent umbrellas, no matter how you want to play it, it's always going to be so much fun. The food is always great, the drinks are always good. I have no complaints about Ballard's, do you? It was a lot of fun. Thank you guys for tuning in. I will see you guys in the next vlog.